Hello guys, in this quick video I'm going to show you how to upgrade the hard drive from a laptop to an SSD without losing any of your data and without the need to reinstall Windows. Okay. So I'm going to do this via an USB to SATA adapter. This is less than $10. You buy it once and you have it forever. And this particular model actually can be turned into an external hard drive. So it has a plastic box. You put the hard drive in that box and with the box you plug it in here and you have an USB external hard drive. So this is dual use and for about $10. There are other ways. You could put both the SSD and the hard drive from the laptop in a working computer and clone the hard drive to the SSD. Acronis True Image, for example, is a software that can do this really well. You could potentially use an external hard drive directly connected to USB, so you copy the data from you clone this hard drive to a single file on that SSD, you put this in the laptop, and then from that SSD, you unpack that file onto this thing. Everything will be exactly as you left it. I have another video showing how to do that with the aid of an external hard drive, if I remember correctly. But in this one, we will simply use this adapter. I don't have this for a very long time, but I decided that it is better to actually buy one than keep using alternative, more complicated methods. This is a 240GB SSD. Inside it's a 500GB hard drive, but only about 60-70GB of it are full, so everything will fit onto this thing with absolutely no issues whatsoever. Make sure the data on your particular hard drive is not bigger than what the new SSD can store. Because if it is, you need to delete or move some of it to other things. So, just plug this thing in. Plug it into a USB port. And in another USB port, I will put in a USB drive with Acronis True Image in this case. There are way more softwares than only Acronis True Image that are able to clone hard drives. That's what I've gotten used to using. Power the laptop on. And hit F12 like crazy. In case of this Dell, I have a lot of videos that show how to enter the boot options menu on many laptop brands. In this case for a Dell it's F12. And I need to boot from a USB storage device. And Yami should pop up any moment now. And I need to go to Acronis True Image. Yami helps you put more than one software on a single USB drive. As you can see, I have more of them and way more in another menu. So, yeah, we'll wait for this to boot up. Should happen fairly quickly. Okay. Once it's booted up, add new disk, because you need to initialize the disk. As you can see, it's not initialized, so it cannot do anything to it. So initialize it, next, MBR, GPT only for drives that are, actually, sorry about that, let me zoom onto the screen itself, because this is what matters now. Let me go back to initialize, because you probably didn't see anything. Tools and utilities, add new disk. This is the one that we put in, the Kingston SSD. Next, MBR for drives less than 2 TB. GPT for drives bigger than that. Unallocated, yes. Proceed. Okay, and now tools and utilities, clone disk, manual in this case, because I want to be able to change some things, and I want to clone this disk. Next to this disk and next, and you have two options: copy partition without changing changes, that's not available, it's good without changes. I think it's not talking about the size, because that will change. Yeah, if you check this one, you will not be able to boot from that disk, so stick with the first one. I thought it's about something else, it is not. And now it's asking us how to convert a 500 gigabytes hard drive to copy it to a 250 gigabytes hard drive. And I don't want proportional, because that would reduce both of the partitions. I want manual, and I will do the things that I want. So let's see about this partition. How can I get rid of it? I'm not even sure if I have the possibility to completely get rid of it. Yeah, this is just edit and properties. Nope, not giving me any option to completely get rid of it. Because this is exactly what I would like to do. Just get rid of this partition. Be back in a second. I could just make it really, 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 really small. My cursor just went away. So I could make it basically non-existent, because there is no data on it. 51 megs, but I'm going to try still and get rid of it altogether. So be back in a moment. My camera's battery just died, because why not? So if you want to get rid of this particular partition fully, it's impossible at first, but I will show you how to do it by the end of the video. If you do have some data that you just do not want to copy, you have, I don't know, whatever, porn that you just do not want on your new hard drive, you can simply go into here, what to exclude, and you just check this whole thing, and then the data from that thing will not be moved, and it will not it will not interfere with your possibility to change the size of this thing. But for the moment I will make it as small as possible. If I could actually, let's see, 0 gigabytes. Yeah, 51 megabytes is the smallest possible, and we want the space after to be zero, because we want it at the end of the drive. Okay, accept in this case. So then this partition, edit once again, we want it increased. This is really annoying to do, because you keep taking the wrong thing. Yeah, exactly as I'm saying now. Okay, I click on the right thing, and my mouse is jumping like crazy the second I lift my finger from it. So I think I'm going to use using the trackpad, and it's really bad in this environment on this Dell. On other laptops it works as in Windows, but in this one, nope. So partition size, I don't know, I put 500 gigs because it's impossible, and it will make it just the max that it can in this situation. And click on accept. So we have the system reserved, we cannot touch that. We have the Windows, the main drive that we want, and just a tiny 51 megs partition that we will delete later. So up until now, we are good to go. Next. Let's just click on options to see what we actually get here. Maybe here we get something to delete it, but I don't think so. From what I know, it's just what to exclude once again. And this is really, really stupid because it will throw me back to the original screen. So this is a fail from Acronis. This is not good at all. Because if you go into the options, it nullifies everything that you already did. So hopefully they got this sorted in newer versions. So I will just redo what I already did before. Okay, we are back here. Let's click next and do not touch options. Doesn't help at all. Proceed. And now it's copying everything from the hard drive inside the laptop to the SSD right here. And it shouldn't really take that long, but it will take an amount of time that is proportional to the size of your hard drive. And obviously not only that, but the data on your hard drive. It could be 2 terabytes, but empty, it will take 1 second. As you can see, the operation succeeded, so I will click OK. If I click the X, it will reboot. I don't want it to reboot, although, yeah, whatever. Let's click the X and hold the power button until we force shut it down. So I don't let it reboot. And it now it's shut down. Okay, remove this. Remove this. Disconnect this. At this moment, we have all our data on the SSD itself. Close the lid. Turn it around. And in my case, just need to open 2 screws. I will move the camera and it will squeak. And these few steps really depend a lot on your particular model. I have in my videos lots of disassemblies for a lot of laptops, but I cannot guarantee you that I have one for yours, so if I don't, you will need to search one on YouTube or on forums. Okay, this is out. I've seen this method on many newer laptops. This bottom part comes out. So you might be in luck if you have a newer model. If it's an older one, try to search again through my videos and see what you get. Okay, remove the screws for the hard drive caddy at first. The main idea is the same. You need to find where you have the hard drive and get it out. And in this particular situation, normally on older laptops, you will slide this like this, like the hard drive like this, and it will come out of the connector. But on newer laptops, they seem to have a connector like this on a cable. So if you are in this particular situation, let's see, we have here a few places where we can put this screwdriver and just spread them slowly apart. And now we should be able to get out our connector from the old hard drive, and it's out. And now we remove the hard drive from the caddy itself. But make sure you remember the correct position of the hard drive inside the caddy, because you will need to put the SSD in exactly the same position, obviously. And yes, this takes a bit of time, and I could have sped up the video, but I've got complaints in the past that why did I speed up that particular part that somebody didn't know how to do. Okay, this is the position that we want our SSD in. So we get this out, put it aside, take the SSD and put it in. And now everything in reverse, and that I will do in high speed because it's just putting the screws back and putting everything back together exactly the way we took it apart. Ok, Okay, and we are booted into Windows from the SSD. The hard drive is right here. Let's see our partitions. As you can see, 200 gigabyte, 23 gigabytes and 50 megabytes, 50.9. So to get rid of the second really small partition, you go to control panel. If you don't already have it, just search for it. Control panel, snap. If you don't see all your icons, you might be in category mode. Switch it to large icons. And you need administrative tools. It was just in front of me. Computer management. And in here, disk management. Ta-da! And this, right click on it and delete volume. Do you want to continue? Yes. Make sure you do not have any data onto that thing. If you have something, it will be gone now. Ta-da! Unallocated. This one, right click, extend volume, next. Available, it is already selected, all that's available, next, finish. And it has been done. Nothing more, nothing less. You can close this thing, close. And now when we go here, we only have one partition, and you will not even be able to see here that it's bigger because we only added about 51 megs, but they are there for sure. So this has been it, guys, for this video. This is the way you copy the content of your old hard drive to an SSD when upgrading via this really useful tool. And at this point, like this, if I would have even that plastic cover, this would be an USB external hard drive and would work for any job that I have for it. But I'm going to use this in another laptop, so not going to put that cover on it. So if you are searching for this thing, this is it. Yeah, really good. Does the job really well. It's even USB 3. So yeah, thank you for watching. Hopefully this video is helpful to you, in which case please give it a like, check out my other videos, subscribe to my channel, and see you in the next one. Bye.